Okay, so talk about intervals. An interval is a measure. Intervals measures the distance between two nodes. So we're going to talk about the generic intervals to start off with. And when two nodes occupy the same line or space, they are what's considered first or a prime apart. So C to C, D to D, E to E, anything that's on the same line in the same space are all first. And accidentals don't make a difference either. So you have your C to C sharp and your D to D sharp or D flat. A sharp to A flat, those are all considered first because they're in the same space. But when you get, as notes become further apart on the staff, your interval type increases. So your C to D, D to E, E to F, anything one step above is called a second. And then you get your C to E, your D to F, your E to G, which are all thirds, and it goes up and so forth. So C to F are four, C to G, fifth, C to A, sixth. Then you go, you've got sevens and eighths. When you get to eighths, so you see one octave C is a perfect octave or an octave. And then you get talking about specific intervals are measured both on the staff and half step on the keyboard. So instead of just using the white keys, you're now adding the black keys and counting up. So we learned that C to D are both generic seconds. Specifically, though, the C to D is one half step larger than the C to D because you're adding one more key, so you're counting black keys. So you will get the major second, so which is C to D is a major second since it's a generic second on the staff or two half steps on the keyboard. Your E to F sharp is another good example. Your major third is made up of four half steps, so your C to E is a major third, your E to G sharp. Then you get your perfect fourth, so C to F, F to B flat. The perfect fifth, your C to G, the B to B, F sharp. A major sixth, C to A, E flat to C. The major seventh, or C to B, D to C sharp. And then finally, you have your perfect eighth, or perfect octave, which is made up of 12 half steps. And then like C to C or D to D, the one octave above. And then you got the terms of like major and perfect refer to the interval's quality. Like only seconds, thirds, sixths, and sevenths can have a major quality. First, fourth, fifth, and eighths use perfect instead. And now we'll talk about the minor scales. When you get to the minor stuff, you know, a minor interval has one less half step than the major. So C to E is a good example of like your major because it has four half steps. And then you get to C to E flat is just three half steps, so that's considered a minor. So your E to G would be a minor, but your E to G sharp would be a major because it's got that one half step above. And then opposite of a minor is you have your augmented, which means it's one half step above. So your C to F is a perfect fifth because it's five half steps, but your C to F sharp is an augmented fourth because it's six half steps. So you like your F to B is augmented fourth, but your F to B flat is a perfect fourth. So major intervals can be augmented by adding a half step. So for example, C to A is a major six because it's got nine half steps, but C to A sharp is an augmented six because it's 10 half steps, one more. And then we get finally into diminished interval has one less half step than perfect. So your C to G is a perfect fifth, your C to G flat would be a diminished fifth because it's six half steps. So your B to F is a diminished fifth, but your B to F sharp is a perfect fifth. So minor intervals can be diminished by subtracting another half step. So major, minor is one below, diminished is one more half step. So it's one whole step, essentially. So like C to B is a major seventh, that's 11 half steps. And C to B flat is a minor seventh, 10 and a half steps. So C to double B flat, we're adding one more half step. That's your diminished seventh, because it's nine half steps. And then we'll talk about like a lot with intervals is interval inversion. So when in music, the verb invert means to move the lowest note in a group an octave higher. So for example, we'll have the perfect fifth from C to G. To invert this interval, we move the lowest note, so we'll move the C an octave higher, which results in a perfect fourth, G to C. So you go from fifth to fourth just by moving that bottom note up an octave. And we'll do with F sharp to B is we'll move F sharp up an octave, so the result is going from a perfect fifth. So you started on a perfect fourth.
So F to B flat.
F sharp to B.
Oh.
F sharp to B is perfect fourth. We'll move that F sharp octave higher, and results in a B to F sharp, which is a perfect fourth, fifth. So we go from a perfect fourth to a perfect fifth. But if it was a perfect fifth and we moved it, it would automatically be a perfect fourth. And perfect intervals will always invert to another perfect interval. And fourths and fifths will invert to each other. So if you have a fourth, it'll go to a fifth, it'll go to a fourth. But a perfect will always go to another perfect. So we'll do C to E. We'll move the lowest one up an octave. So that results in a minor six. So you have E to C. Then we'll do E to G, you know, that moves it up to G to E, which is a major six, because you're still counting the half steps up the piano. Minor intervals and major intervals invert to each other. So a minor will go to a major will go to a minor. Thirds and sixths will intervert and will go to each other. So you have your fourth to fifth to fourth, third to sixth, sixth to seventh. So when we talk about C to B, which is almost a perfect octave, we'll move that C up to B, and that becomes just a major second because it's right there beside it. And second and sevenths invert to each other. So you have fourth to fifth, fifth to fourth, third to sixth, sixth to seventh, second to seventh, seventh to seconds. So she's going up because perfect will always be perfect, minor will always be to major, and vice versa. And then you get diminished and augmented will always go together. So minor to major to minor, perfect to perfect, diminished to augmented. And good example is we'll take an augmented fourth C to C F sharp. We'll move the lowest note. So we'll have F sharp to C, which makes it a diminished fourth. Since we have an augmented fourth, we it also plays that same low fourth to fifth to fourth. And that's pretty much intervals.